Hello friends, welcome to IBPS Guide. So in this session we'll be talking about the basics of quants. Right, basics of quants. So topics we are covering is fraction, percentage, multiplication, base method and matrix method. In examination you can hardly give 20 to 30 seconds for a problem, but if you solve the problem using traditional method it will take you 1 to 2 minutes, so you'll not be able to attempt all the problem. So in order to solve the problem quicker, you need to learn these concepts and techniques which I am teaching today. Okay, let us begin. So this is the fraction and this is the percentage equivalent of this of the fraction. Okay, so let me take an example. That is, 1 is equivalent to 100, half is equivalent to 50%, 1 by 3 is equivalent to 33, 1 by 3%, 1 by 4 is equivalent to 25%, 1 by 5 is equivalent to 20%. Similarly, the rest of the values we have. Let me show you how we have come to this derivation. Is 50%, you can write it as 50 by 100, so 50, that is 2 times, so 1 by 2. Okay, so let me take some more example. 20%, that is 20 by 100, that is 1 times, that is 5 times. Let me take one more example. Suppose this we take, that is 16 2 by 3 percentage. That is 16 into 3, that is 48 plus 2, that would be 50 by 3 divided by 100. This 1 times, that is 2 times, that is 1 by 6. Similarly, we can derive the rest of the values, but you cannot derive the rest of the values in examination. You have to remember it. Okay. If somebody in the examination, if you see 8 1 by 3, immediately it should come to your mind it is equivalent to 1 by 12. If you see 6 1 by 4, it should come to your mind that it is equivalent to 1 by 16. Okay. So till from 1 to this 1 by 40 you have to remember this value. You can take a snapshot of this table and save in your desktop or anywhere in the phone. So this value, how we have come, we have derived from the previous values. So 1 by 8 is equivalent to 12 1 by 2 percentage, 3 by 8 is equivalent to 36 3 by 2 percentage. Okay, so this could be written as 37 1 by 2 percentage. Let me take one more example. That is 5 by 8. How could we write? We know that 1 by 8 is equivalent to 12 1 by 2 percentage. So into 5 by 8, that is 12 5 is 60, 5 by 2. Okay. Now if you divide 5 by 2, we'll get 2 times 4, 1 is the remainder. So we could write it as add this 2 to 60, that is 62, remainder is 1 by 2 percentage. Similarly, you have derived the rest of the values. Okay. So let me take a first example. We know that 1 by 6 is equivalent to 16 2 by 3 percentage. Then what is the value of 5 by 6? All you have to do is multiply this by 5. Okay. That is 15 into 5 into 16, that is 80, 5 into 2, 10 by 3 percentage. Okay. So this 3 times 9, 1 is the remainder. So 83, 1 by 3 percentage. Let me take another example. What is the value of 3 by 4 in percentage? Okay, we know that 1 by 4 is equivalent to 25 percentage, then 3 by 4 will be equivalent to 75 percentage. Now know what is the value of 5 by 8 in percentage. 1 by 8 we know it is equivalent to 12 1 by 2 percentage, so 5 by 8 will be 5 into 12, that is 60, 5 by 2 percentage. It goes 2 times 4, 1 is the remainder, that is 62, 1 by 2 percentage. In examination, please don't write this step, you should directly come to this step. Okay. Let me take some more example. What is the value of 5 by 16 in percentage? We know that 1 by 16 is 6, 1 by 4 percentage. Then what is 5 by 16? 5 by 16 is 31 1 by 4 percentage. Then what is the value of 7 by 8? 1 by 8 we know it is equivalent to 12 1 by 2 percentage. Then 7 by 8 will be 84 plus 3, that is 12 into 7 will be 84, 7 by 2 percentage. So this could be written as 3 times, that is 87 1 by 2 percentage. What is 3 by 8? That is 3 times 12, 1 by 2 percentage. We have 37, 1/2%. Now we move on to the next topic, that is conversion of percentage to fraction. Okay, now percentage 33, 1/3%, we know from the table it is equivalent to 1/3, but if someone asks you what is the value of 133 1/3%, so you could split it as 100 plus 33 1/3%. So this is 1, this is 1/3, so we get it as 4/3. Okay, let us take more example, that is 257 1/7% in fraction. This could be written as 200% plus 57 1/7%. This could be written as 2 plus, that is 4 times by 7. So 7 into 2, 14 plus 4, that is 18/7. How we have come to this? So here 1/7 is equivalent to 14, 2/7%. Okay, if we multiply it by 4, we get it as 57 1/7%. So let us take one more last example, that is 443 1/3% is what in fraction. This could be written as 400 plus 10% into plus 10% plus 33 1/3%. We know that 400 is equivalent to 4, 10% could be written as 1/10, and 33 1/3 could be written as 1/3. This is equivalent to 30, 120 plus 3 plus 10, that is equivalent to 133/30. Alright, so hope you understood this. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is dealing with addition and subtraction of mixed numbers. Alright, suppose let us take the first example. What is the value of 27 minus 8 2/3? Okay, I'll show you the longer method first, then I'll show you the shortcut. Then first we need to split it as 8 minus 2/3. Okay, sorry, here we should write 2/3. So 27 minus 8 is how much? 19 minus 2/3. So we need to remove this subtractions, and for that we need to subtract 1 and add 1 minus 2/3. So 19 minus 1 is 18, 1/3 is 1/3. So this is the value. Let us take one another, that is addition one, that is 78 plus 4 3/7 is what in fraction. So in this case, first I need to show you the shortcut of this. Okay, first, so that 27, instead of writing like this, all you can do is increase it by 1. The 8 plus 1 is 9, so it will be 27 minus 9, that is 18. Difference of this two, that is 1 divided by the denominator, that is 18 1/3. Let me take one more example using shortcut method, this time always solving, that is 36 minus 4 3/4. What will be the equivalent of this? This could be increase this by 1, that is 5. 36 minus 5 would be 31. Difference of this two is 1, and divided by the denominator, that is 31 1/4. Okay, so let us take one addition problem. These all are involving subtraction, that is why we need to add 1, but in addition we don't need to add 1. So I'll explain with an example. 78 plus 4 3/7, what is the equivalent of this? All you need to do is add this 2, that is 82, and write this as it is. Okay, let me take one more example. 47 plus 6 5/2. Here you need to see that you cannot just add this and write this as like this. 47 plus 6 would be 53 5/2. This is wrong, because this numerator is greater than the denominator. First we need to convert this into more simpler form. For that we can write it as 47 plus 6 plus 5/2. So this 47 plus 6 plus, this goes 2 times, that is 2 plus 1/2. Okay, so we can write it as 47 plus 8, that is 55 1/2. Okay, hope you understood all this concept. Now I want you to take down some problem, and please mention this problem in the comment section, what values you got. What is the value of 5/7 in percentage form? What is the value of 437 1/7% in fraction form? Then what is the value of 567 1/7 in that is fraction form, not fraction form, yes, in fraction form, this percentage in fraction, and one more, 32 minus 9 1 by 5, what is the simplified value. Okay, this task I have given you, please solve this. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is multiplication. This technique of multiplication is only applicable for 2 digit. Okay, if you apply, it could be applied for more than 2 digit also, but it will take the same time as the traditional method. So please apply it for only for 2 digit. So let me take the first example, that is 22 into 48. What is the value of this? You can write it as 48. So 8 into 2 is 16, 6, write the carry as 1, 8 into 2 is 16, that is 16, 4 into 2 is 8, we get it as 24, plus 1 we had from previous, so that is 25, write the 5, carry, we have 2, write it as like this, then 4 into 2 is 8, plus 2 is 10, 1056, this is the final method. But if you do using traditional method, you have to go the lengthy method, that is 8 into 2 is 6, 1, 8 into 2 is 16, 17, so 4 into 2 8, 4 into 2 8, alright, 6, 5, 1 carry, that is 1056, so we get the same value, but this is taking much lesser time. So let me give you another example, 78 into 44, what is the value of this? You have to write it as 78 into 44, that is 32, 3 carry, 28, 4 in 8, 8 into 4 is 32, we keep it as carry as 3, now this is 28, and this 2 is 32, that is 60, plus 3 will be 63, 3, 6 carry, 20, 7 into 4 is 28, plus 6 is 34, that is 3432. You can see with traditional method also you will get the same answer. Let us take one, some more example. What is the value of 27 into 74? Write it like this, 27 into 74, that is 7 4 is 28, 2 carry, 4 into 2 8, 49. What will get it as? 57, 8 plus 7 is 7, 1 carry, 57. Okay, write it as 7, 5 carry, 7 into 2 14, 14 plus 5 is 19, that is 1978. So this is the value. Sorry, I made some mistake thing. Let me see, check it once more. 7 4 is 28, 8 2 carry, 4 into 2 is 8, 7 into 7 is 49, that is 57. 57, 5, 7 into 2, 14 plus 5, that is 19, alright, that is 1978. If I made some mistake, please mention it in the comment so that other student will get to know that, I made the mistake. Let us move on to the next problem, that is, what is the value of 36 into 83, alright, so 6 into 3 is 18, 1 carry, 3 into 3 is 9, 48, 6 into 3 is 8, 1 carry, 3 into 3 9, 8 5 is 40, 48 plus 9 would be, 48 plus 9 is 9 plus 9 7, 1 carry 57, plus 1 is 58, 5 carry, 8 into 3 is 24, plus 5 would be 29, 2988, alright. So these are the problems that I have taken as example. I want you to solve some problems on your own. Please don't use calculator or traditional method, please use the method which I have shown you. What is the value of product of these two? Product of 34 into 73, what is the value? Then 23 into 54, what is the value? And 18 into 76, what is the value? Now let us take another topic, move on to the next topic, that is Bayes method of multiplication. Bayes method of multiplication. So what is Bayes? Bayes is nothing but 100, 200, 300, 400 and so on. So let us move on to the first example. First example would be 107 into 97. What is the value? So this method of multiplication is only applicable when these numbers are closer to the bases. So which base it is closer to? 100. So 100 is the base. This 100 and 7 could be written as plus 7. What is, how much it is more than 100? That is 7 times 7 plus 7. How much it is? 97 is how much less than 100? That is 3. So this would be, what is the 107 minus 3 is 104. 97 plus 7 is 104. Base is 100, so 0, 0. 7 into 3 it is minus 21, that is plus minus, to multiply we will get it as minus 1. So what is the value of this? 104,00,219,73,10,379 is the final value. Let us take one more example. 91 into 102, what is the value? So 91, how much it is greater than, less than 100, that is 9. 100 into how much it is greater than 100? 2. So if you add this 2, this will be 93, and if you subtract from here also, you will get 93. So you could write 93 as it is. Then what was the base? Base was 100, so multiply it by 100 and subtract minus 18, so we'll get it as 9282 is the final answer. Okay, in examination you don't have to solve this, you just do it in your mind, try to solve it in your mind itself. So let us move on to the next problem, example number 3. Okay, so what is the multiplication of 297 into 303? So 297, how much it is, what is the base here? Base is 300. So how much it is less than 300? That is minus 3. And 303, how much it is greater than 303? So this could be written as 300. 297 plus 3 is 300. Here also 303 minus 3 is 300. So what was the base? Was 300. And multiplication of these two numbers is minus 9. So this could be written as 900,000 minus 9. So this would be 89991. This is the final value. So hope you understood this. Let us take one more problem with a bigger digit. So 407 into 402. Okay, what is the value of this? So this could be 407 is how much it is greater than 400. So let me write the base first. Base is 400. How much it is greater than 400? 7. 402, how much it is greater than 400? 2. Okay, so 407 plus 2 is 409. 402 plus 7 is also 409. Okay, into 400. This was the base. So multiplication of this would be 14. So let me solve this. 409 into 4, 6 times 3, 4, 0, 0, 3 times 4 into 2, 16. So 1636 plus 14. So 1636 14 is the final value. So hope you understood all these problems. Now please try to solve this on your own. So the examples that I'm giving you is 409 into 393, what is the value, and 707 into 702 is what is the value. Please mention it in the comment. Alright, let us move on to the last topic of this session, that is matrix method. So let us take the first example, that is 78 into 52. Now if you see, these are not closer to the bases, so we cannot use the base method. So let us take with another approach, that is matrix method. You need to create two bars like this. You write the first digit, that is 7, then second digit 8, from this number is 5, and the second digit is this much. So 7 into 5 is 35, 7 into 2 is 14, 8 5 times is 40, 8 into 2 is 16. Now you need to separate it in diagonal fashion. Okay, now you have to write it as 16. So write 6, what was 1 extra, so keep it as carry. 40 plus 14 would be 54, plus 1 is 55, 5 carry, so 35 plus 5 is 40, 4056. Okay, let us move on to the next example. Hope you understood it. If you don't understand, please mention it in the comment. Now 46 into 27, what is the value of this? So this you need to write it in matrix form first, that is 46 into 27. Okay, 4 into 2 is 8, 7 4 is 28, 6 into 2 is 12, 7 6 is 42. Okay, you need to separate it like this. So this could be written as 2, 4 is the extra, it is 30, 40, 44, 4 carry, that is 12, 1, 2, 4, 2 is the final answer. So let us take another example with 3 digit, 142 into 257. So write it as in a similar fashion, first digit 1, 4 and 2, similarly 2, 5 and 7. Okay, the multiplication of 1 into 2 is 2, 1 into 5 is 5, 1 into 7 is 7, 4 into 2 is 8, 4 into 5 is 20, 7 into 4 is 28, 2 into 2 is 4, 5 into 2 is 10, 7 into 2 is 14. Okay, you need to separate it like this. Now write it as 4, 1 is extra. So 28 plus 10 is 38, plus 1 is 39, 9, 3 carry. 20 plus 7 is 27, 30, 34, 4, 3 carry. 8 plus 5 is 13, plus 3 is 16, 6, 1 carry. 2 plus 1 is 3. So this is the value. Let us take one more example, that is mixture of 2 digit and 3 digit number. 40, that is 743 into 28, suppose. What is the value? So please write the smaller one here, that is 28743. Okay, so 7 into 2 is 14, 2 into 4 is 8, 2 into 3 is 6, 8 5 is 48, 56, 8 into 4 is 32, 8 3 is 24. Separate it in a similar fashion like this. So write it as 24 could be written as 2, 2 is carry. 32 plus 6 is 38, plus 2, that is 44 carry. 56 plus 8 is 64, plus 4 is 68, 6 carry. 14 plus 6 is 20. So this is the final value. Hope you understood all this concept. This concept are very useful. When we see the problems, when you apply these problems, this concept, then you'll understand how much quickly you can solve this problem. The problems, okay. So let me give you the first example. These are the homeworks. That is 37 into 78. What is the value? Then 46 into 32. What is the value? Then 540 into 205. Is what is the value? Then 97 into 704. What is the value? These are the concept which I taught you. Please understand the concept very carefully. If you don't understand once, please watch it twice or thrice. And this fraction, these values must be remembered by you by heart. Suppose if you see this value 71 by 7 percentage, it immediately should come to your mind that it is equivalent to 1 by 14. So please do give a like if you like the video, and thank you. We'll see you in the next session.